Proverbs chapter 10, verse 19. In the multitude of words there wanteth no sin, but he that refraineth his lips is wise. Ladies and gentlemen, the Spirit of the Lord told me to speak to you about something that would seem very simple, but is not for many. And that is just learning to be quiet. You know what time it is. Let's get it.
Heaven's above me, hell is beneath me. How in the world could these devils ever defeat me? Heaven's above me, hell is beneath me. How in the world could these devils ever defeat me? Heaven's above me, hell is beneath me. How in the world could these devils ever defeat me? Heaven's above me, hell is beneath me. How in the world could these devils ever defeat me?
Accepting the fact that my goal is the top, then knowing heaven is in that spot, keeps driving me nonstop. Never allowing hell to defeat me. It's not possible as long as it's beneath me. Nothing sent from there could ever reach.
What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? This is Apostle Makhario coming to you all again. And the Spirit of the Lord just wanted me to speak to you is something very simple. Simply deep. I'll just put it that way. One of the ways for people to learn to grow in God is to learn to be quiet. Many times people put themselves in trouble, even with God, because they're constantly talking. They're in trouble with man, and then when they go to God, they're in trouble with God because they constantly are speaking and never listening. The Bible declares in James chapter 1, it's funny, I wasn't even going to use this verse, chapter 1, verses 19 and 20, wherefore let every man be swift to hear, slow to speak, slow to wrath, for the wrath of man worketh not the righteousness of God. It says swift to hear, means you need to be quick to listen, slow to speak, slow to wrath, for the wrath of man worketh not the righteousness of God. I brought to you Proverbs chapter 10, verse 19, where it says, in the multitude of words there wanteth no sin, but he that refraineth his lips is wise. So it says, in much speaking, there's no desire of someone sinning. But if a person refrains their lips, that means they stop talking, they silence themselves, it says they're wise. See, many times people get caught up in wanting to speak everything that they think or everything that they feel, and everything that a person thinks or everything that a person feels may not be correct in life, or it's definitely not correct according to God. So we need to learn to refrain our lips from speaking so much. Many times people miss it even in prayer. And you say, well, what do you mean? I mean, they pray to God, and they're talking, and then they get up and go about their business. They never sit still to listen to God's response. They never sit still or quiet themselves to be able to hear the voice of God. So they run and they talk to God in prayer, and they're just in their mind, they're so busy that they get up and they just keep going about their day, not ever listening or quieting themselves, or they just talk during the whole conversation. You know, communication with God is not just you talking, it's also you listening. That ties into everything that I've been teaching you as well about studying, fasting, and praying, and ties into what I've been teaching you about being able to know God and prophecy. See, prophecy is not just you talking to God, because if you're constantly talking, he can never tell you anything. If you're constantly speaking, he can never reveal anything because you're constantly speaking. So the whole time that he's trying to reveal something, you're talking. There are so many people I know whose lives are in shambles simply because they don't know how to be quiet. And they're Christians, or they claim to be Christians. There are so many people I know that are in trouble spiritually, and Satan is just bombarding and destroying their life because they don't know how to be quiet. And then when you try to tell them, they get attitude, they get upset, but they're not even listening to God. Let me take you here, because I want you to understand what I mean, that many of you even get in trouble in prayer because you're constantly talking and never listening to God. Ecclesiastes chapter 5, we'll start at verse 3. It says, for a dream cometh through the multitude of business, right? And a fool's voice is known by multitude of words. So that's tying into what I just gave you. It says a dream comes through the multitude of business. And it says a fool's voice is known by multitude of words. So everyone knows when a fool is speaking because they're constantly talking. And they know them to be a fool because their words are many, which means they're never listening. They're never actually allowing God to speak to them or someone else to give them wisdom or knowledge or understanding or insight into their problems. And because they think they have the answer for their problem, they're constantly talking, but then they're talking about their problems. It's never a solution. Verse 4, Ecclesiastes chapter 5, it says, "When thou vowest a vow unto God, defer not to pay it. For he hath no pleasure in fools. Pay that which thou hast vowed. You vow to God by your mouth." It says, "Better is it that thou shouldest not vow than that thou shouldest vow and not pay. Suffer not thy mouth to cause thy flesh to sin. Neither say thou before the angel that it was an error. Wherefore should God be angry at thy voice and destroy the work of thine hands? For in the multitude of dreams and many words, there are also diverse vanities, but fear thou God." So it's saying, if you go up to verse 6, suffer not your mouth to cause your flesh to sin. Neither say before the angel that it was an error or a mistake, or I said it by accident. It says, "Wherefore should God be angry at thy voice and destroy the work of thine hands?" So it's also telling you here that God could be angry with your voice. It tells you, it says, "For in the multitude of dreams and many words, there are also diverse vanities, but fear thou God." Which means that you speaking a lot can be diverse vanities, which are vain and foolish things that God won't honor, because you're constantly talking. So you vow a vow unto God, you don't pay it, because you said it with your mouth, but you don't actually do it. And all that I've been teaching you all, it ties into everything I've been teaching you all, which is when you say something, honor what you say, especially to God. Because the more that you honor what you say, the more that God can bless your life. The more that you say things and you don't keep your word, I taught you, I've been teaching you all this for years. Keep your word to people, keep it to God. And the more that you keep your word, the more that God can bless you and give you more of his anointing. There are so many people I know that don't know how to be still before God. Satan has bombarded their mind with so many things. I even talk to them about this sometimes, just in passing. We're talking and they're like, "Man, I can't do anything if I don't have some noise around me." And I tell them, that's a demonic spirit. There's no reason that you should constantly have noise around you. If you can't learn to sit still and be quiet, God can't do anything with you. If you feel the need, and they claim to be Christian, if you feel the need to constantly speak, constantly have even praise and worship music, or what people consider praise and worship music, if you feel the need to always have noise, God can't speak. There's no peace in your life. And God is a God of peace. He's not a God of chaos and confusion and anger. The Bible says God is not the author of confusion. So you need to learn to be still before God. You need to learn to be quiet before God. Even when you look at the disciples, or even Christians nowadays, that are around people that are highly anointed, one thing about us is we're very short because we don't like to hear foolishness. If you talk to real apostles, real prophets, people that, real evangelists, people that really teach and know the word of God or know God, we hate to hear foolish things. I've told you all of this about me a lot. I hate to hear foolishness. And the other thing that I strongly hate, which God hates, is to hear people that just talk and they don't realize that they're talking Satan into their lives. They're talking chaos into their lives because they're constantly running their mouth. They're talking and not realizing what they're saying. And I told you all that God created the world and everything therein, except for man, with his words. God spoke it and it happened. Go back in Genesis. But it says he formed man from the dust of the ground. So he used his hands, which means God has hands. So you have to understand, when you speak, when a person is constantly speaking, they're constantly talking, God cannot download or give them anything. And that's scriptural. And I just gave you all three or four scriptures, maybe more. I'm going to give you another one. I'm going to end you with Jesus like I always do, or I try to always do. Sometimes the Lord will just have me end somewhere else, but it's important that you understand. Too much talking can cause you not only to sin, but it can cause you to miss God completely. And in the day of judgment, you'll be judged for those words as well. Jesus said this here, Matthew chapter 12, 34 through 37. O generation of vipers, how can you, being evil, speak good things? For out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaketh. I talked to you all about that verse a lot. Verse 35, it says, a good man out of the good treasure of his heart bringeth forth good things, and an evil man out of the evil treasure bringeth forth evil things. Verse 36 and 37 are super key. 36, it says, but I say unto you that every idle word that men shall speak, they shall give an account thereof in the day of judgment. For by thy words thou shalt be justified, and by thy words thou shalt be condemned. So Jesus said, every idle word that you speak out of your mouth, he said, you're going to give an account for in the day of judgment. Every idle word. That's why the Bible even talks about not foolish jesting, not making a lot of foolish and vain jokes. And then Jesus said in verse 37, for by thy words thou shalt be justified, and by thy words thou shalt be condemned. So this ties into what I just told you, that when you speak a lot, you're speaking Satan and chaos into your life, especially when you don't know what you're speaking about. So it's so important to speak the right things, to speak godly things. And if anyone, and I tell you all about this also, if anyone is speaking something over your life, you bind up and you rebuke those words in the name of Jesus. You don't have to say it out loud to them. Sometimes I do. I'm quick to tell them right away. And sometimes the Lord will just say, I say it under my breath. It could be a manager or someone talking, and they're talking foolishness. But you need to learn to take captive your words. I love you, Jesus. I'm going to do another part to this because another verse just came to me, and I'm not going to give it to you now. I'm going to leave you with the words of Jesus. So important to learn to be quiet, to be silent, even before God. I love you all. I will see you all again soon. May God bless. We are out.
Heaven's above me, hell is beneath me. How in the world could these devils ever defeat me? Heaven's above me, hell is beneath me. How in the world could these devils ever defeat me? Heaven's above me, hell is beneath me. How in the world could these devils ever defeat me? Heaven's above me, hell is beneath me. How in the world could these devils ever defeat me?
Accepting the fact that my goal is the top, then knowing heaven is in that spot, keeps driving me nonstop. Never allowing hell to defeat me. It's not possible as long as it's beneath me. Nothing sent from there could ever reach me.